Ganze Fashion Team im Start. Buongiorno, Davide.
Buongiorno, everybody. The winner of the coming toss is a team from Latvia. They will start serving from my right hand side. Enjoy the game.
Thank you very much, Davide. Good from the panel. It's a good sport to thank you. welcome to the women's bronze medal game between Canada and Latvia. First referee from Italy, buongiorno, Davide Crescentini. Assisted by Martin Kammer of Österreich. Teams first, wearing the white uniforms, representing Latvia. European Champions 2019, fourth place at the four-star event in Sochi this year. Player number one, former under-18 and under-22 European champion, Peter Fjellenschaft, with 23 years young, 184 goal. Welcome, Pina Raudina! European champion 2016. It's his fifth season. She has one career win. 24 years young, 179. So this is Anastasia Kravchenko. Their opponents wearing the red uniforms representing Canada, reigning world champions. Start champion 2018, team of the year 2019. The player with number one was named three times as best blocker. She finished fifth at the Rio Olympics. She's 196 goal, 34 years young. Say hello to Sarah Pollan! Her partner with number two was named as best defense player and best record 2019. She has six career wins. She's 175 tall. From Toronto, make some noise for Melissa Yamada Perez!
Both teams then out onto court. This one is about to get underway. I hope wherever you're watching from, whatever you're watching on, you're sitting comfortably and ready for this one. Latvia in white serving, Canada in red receiving this, the bronze medal match from the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour event here in Stade, Switzerland. And it's Canada who get the opening point. Krasenica looking for first side out chance, not happening. And there's a break point chance already here for Canada. Hard hit from Melissa. Canada up 2-0. Clever little roll just over the top of the block and away and out of the reach of Pavan. And she does have a very long reach. Bit of a chase for Pavan. That won't come back. Latvia level up very quickly. Clever little change up from Pavan. Looked to go cross, held the defender in that place. Then a crafty little roll just over the block to the line. Out of the heel of the hand. No chance for Latvia. Seneca not getting past the block. This is a bright start for Canada. Melissa has a little look and gets the roll, but that's really well played. Krepsenica getting in and onto it. But an equally good pickup, if not better, from Melissa. But a wonderful block. Gradina puts the ball down. Latvia back to within one. That was a hard-fought point for Latvia. Fabulous rally. Latvia will be delighted with the way it went. Side switch, one in it, Krasenica serving, Pavan the target. Doesn't work out. Worked off the block in a way. Pavan was there to make sure there was no line available, at least not from a swing. And while she's able to stop it, she can't get it to land in court. Gardina having to reach up high to try and get into the hitting zone that Pavan is in, but once you do that, and your hands are just straight up above you, it's very difficult to get that ball to go back over the net. Certainly not down on a steep angle. It ends up on the same side as Latvia. Canada with the point, with the ball, leading by two in the first set of this bronze medal match. Seneca the target yet again. Oh, that was almost perfect, but almost just isn't good enough at this level. That ball needed to have tagged the line. The high roller of the mark. Fabulous blocking. Pavan takes away the power. Krasenica was after it. And there's just a little word to the referees. They weren't happy with that set from Gradina to Krasenica. And they're just letting the ref know, trying to get in his head. Won't happen though. Top swing, Gradina getting the side out on Latvia, three behind on service. It's already become a tough first set for them. We'll go to the second side switch, Canada leading by four. Nice pass. Tidy side out. Good touch. Chance to get back to within two. Oh, well taken. Hand was up early, never going to hit that ball hard, but doesn't matter. You've still got to be able to know where it's going to go as a defender, and it was way too far away from Melissa to get after it. Swing from Melissa cross court keeps Canada with a comfortable gap between them and Latvia. The break doesn't work for Latvia. It's another point for Canada. They're moving away now in this first set. Melissa, even though she had no block, still cutting it away from the defender. Excellent swing. Skies on that one. Canada's side out game is supreme at the moment. There's nothing Latvia can do to break it down. A little bit too much on that one, but as if it's off the hands, it doesn't really matter. We'll go to the technical timeout. Canada are in the best possible place. It's not quite happening for Latvia at the moment. Straight out of the 80s, aren't they? It's all back in fashion now. Even some of the premium range sunglasses are now having a little nod back to the 80s. Just not quite the sort of a mix of 80s and 90s. We've got that 80s styling and then the 90s colouring. Because back in the 80s we had that styling. Oh, that's some classic dancing. That's straight into the 21st century. We had the glasses that were... The star was seeing now 80s, but then the colours were that Miami pastel-y colour, which was synonymous with the 80s, but then the 90s was the more fluorescent colours, and now we've got that mix coming through with some of the fashion items currently being worn around the world. Side out achieved. The net touch from Pavan, giving the point to Latvia. Well played. Right, again, looks like going cross, great to start in disguise, and then into the other side of the court. Just creep through. Well, that's not coming back. Ace serve for Canada, and now the gap increases. A Attempted throw down, not working. Chance for Gradina. Has to go with her left hand as well. Melissa, though, onto it. And a brilliant swing from her, tagging the line. Doesn't get much better than that, does it? They're calling the timeout as this set is starting to slip. Side out needed. Kravseneca trying to get it. Won't get it though, at least not yet. Melissa, good touch by Gradina. Oh, good hustle as well from her to get that ball back off the block, but Pavan's going to have a swipe at it. Good touch by Kravseneca, but it doesn't come back. And it's Canada with another break point. And they now lead by six. And need four to take the first set. Great hustle on both sides, but Melissa, excellent in defence. Pavan, too tall, too strong, too good at the net. Touch, really good pickup, and a clever play. That's not easy to do. You make that pickup, full stretch, full effort, back up out of the sand, then you've got to have the presence of mind to know exactly what you're going to do with the ball, get yourself in a position where you can do something with the ball. Right to where Melissa was waiting. This could be 19-11. It is 19-11. Latvia have no answers at the moment to what Canada are doing. A blip from Canada. That's how they'll think of it. Set point now for Canada. A bit tight, well covered. That will come back over brilliantly by Melissa. Oh, well played. Good up again. Latvia not giving up, not giving in. And they save the first set point. What a fabulous rally. for the set. Taken. Pavan off the block and away. And Canada lead by one, set to nothing in this bronze medal match. Away we go with the second set. Canada serving. They lead 1-0 over Latvia. Latvia hoping to try and take this one to force it into a decider. Oh, not like that, they won't. That net going up and down, but only because the ball touched it mid-rally. Or did it? Oh, there's a net touch there from Pavan. I hope there's a challenge coming. Indeed there will be, and we could already see it, so we know that that's going to go the way of Latvia. Here we go, ball and net. Well spotted by Latvia. Perfectly placed. Pavan. Well, as I thought it was going to go wide and left it, so we need to be thinking again. Wasn't easy. It's an ace serve, and Latvia are off to an absolute fire in this second set. High hands, defense not quite working. That's perfectly placed. That's a brilliant Pachompo special from Graudina. Over the block, over the defender, on the line. This is not going the way Canada thought it might. Thank you. a big hit. Sometimes you get the feeling that Pavan has to tell herself to actually hit the ball hard. Touch against Skradina. Canada back to within three. Line was the call. And that's exactly where the ball went. Brilliant from Latvia. It's getting better and better for them. Late movement, and then it's too late to do anything about that serve. And they've called the timeout. Seneca, big jump serve from her. That's well dealt with by Melissa. And then she's got options to put the ball pretty much wherever she wants. Movement adjustment steps to come in and then have the swing on the ball and a very good wrap to the line. Good hustle. Oh, somehow stays in play. Latvia come again. Yeah. Seneca can't finish it off. That may well have been the point that would have decided that set. 11-5. Be a massive lead. 6-10. Canada still in with the shout. Brilliant. That caught everybody by surprise. Too tight, too easy for Gradina. That point could well be the difference now. Six ahead. Too far in front. In fact, that was almost touched first by Gradina. If it was, it would have been an illegal attack. Pavan using Gradina's hands well that time. Another chance here for Canada. That's well taken. Did that before in the previous match. You're allowed to set that ball over so long as it goes between your shoulders and there's no turning of your shoulders when you're setting the ball. It's got to land in. Really looking like there's much of a way back in this for Canada, especially if they can't get the serves in. That means they can't put Latvia under any pressure. They can't get any break points. And that gives license for Kravseneca to go after it from the serving line, which she does. That one not clipping the sideline, so side out achieved. Too good an angle for that to be played by Melissa. The hustle is paying dividends for Latvia. Surely we're going to be going to a decider. That was a brilliant pickup by Kravseneca. Points are okay, but they need break points. They can afford a couple of errors, but not many. They don't want to allow Canada to get into a rhythm, to get any momentum. Good touch. That's a really good chase from Melissa. Well, we're beginning a bit of a comeback here, our Canada. One clipping the block, which is why Melissa had to go for it. Desperate attempt. It's Latvia who are going to take that point, and Latvia who are now three away from taking the set. Make that two away from taking the set. Brilliant blocking from Gradina. Jumps into the angle, denies Pavan. Just about works. Not a question of if, but when Latvia are going to take this set. Gradina to bring up set point. She does that in style. It's not happened for Canada. They don't get the ball in, and Latvia take the set at the first time of asking. 21-13. We're going to a decider. Here are stats from the set. A couple of aces for Latvia. They out-attacked Canada. They made less errors. They made more blocks. That's the perfect start for Latvia in this race to 15. They have lots of momentum that they took from that second set victory. They've carried it over here. First point. Oh, almost kept in play. That was brave effort from Gradina. So close to the referee stand. Bring it back into play, first time or second time of asking. Oh, big hit. Well, well played. That quick movement of the body sent the ball into the bottom of the net. When it hits the bottom of the net, it can come out and you can play it. And then look at that, Melissa. Picture perfect into the corner. Good serve from Pavan, that one, a tester, which Seneca didn't like. Oh, brilliant. Melissa returned and she's chasing that one. She's thinking it's going out because she can't quite see where she is on the court. Does this get any better in terms of how to play the jumbo and beat the defender in the corner you're playing the ball to? I think not. Big swing. Melissa to serve. Has to come back. Another chance here for Latvia. Gradina will have a go. Turns it to the line brilliantly. Latvia back to within one. All square. Krabsenova. Oh, easy for me to say. Krabsenova with that very good serve. And now means Latvia have a chance to go in front. Good up from Melissa. Cheeky little play really from Pavan. There wasn't much more she could do with that ball, but to just get a hand on it and send it over. Gardina has gone up and then pressed instead of just going across. If she'd gone across the net, she would have stopped that one from coming over. Pavan getting her serving instruction from Melissa. There wasn't a line available, only cross court, didn't matter. Krabsenova, goodness me, get a grip, Clayton. Krabsenova, still able to get that one away cross court. That was a fabulous swing. Gardina. Trying to probe the middle of court. Put Melissa onto it. She's always going to be the one who'll take the ball where she can. She's so used to being the main passer anyway. Player that everybody picks on. Canada then holding on to a slender lead. Latvia trying to side out to get back level. And an unforced error means Canada just edge away. This race to 15, this halfway mark really just under for Canada here. They'll be pleased to have got that break point. Side out achieved. This could be a chance to get level. Oh, and it is a chance taken. And the game has turned again. We are meandering our way to deciding who's going to take the bronze. It's certainly not been a straight path for either of these two teams. Great hand setting. That means that Pavan had an easy swing chance. Will change ends again. And at the side switch, Canada have their noses in front. It's a net touch, surely, against Melissa. Was it Gradina? Oh, definitely a net touch by Melissa. That's got to be Latvia's point. Well, I can't believe we're having to challenge that. I can't believe that the referee didn't see that. I know that the second ref is on the side of the blocker, but even so, I mean, not only, I mean, that's caught Melissa. She did well to not bring the net down. There's a, yeah, there's a net touch. There's a net touch, and then she falls into it. There's an even more of a net touch. It wasn't just at the top of the net. She brought it down. No net touch that time. Melissa hammers it away. Canada lead by one. Square. Anastasia's serve, no good. Handing the initiative to Canada. Tough to defend that. Melissa, she was behind the block. Didn't really step into that and then say, okay, I'm going to take this small space. You can try and force you to go the other way. Pavan makes that one look easy. Where we'll see what Latvia have got and what they can come up with, and that's what they've got. A brilliant swing on the angle from Gradina. And that time really opening up to get her swing through that. A lot of times she stays square onto the net, Gradina, and then just gets her arm through the ball. Well, that's a good fake out. Just a continuation block. Right on to Anastasia. There's a chance here for Latvia to go in front, but it doesn't happen. Well played. Those are angles you can't defend. Angle it back towards her partner. Melissa quite high up into the court, so a lot of room in behind for that ball to be placed, and that's exactly where Anastasia has put it. Chase is on, it won't come back. Canada now edge in front, and they have match point. This is how close this match has been. It has gone point for point in this third set. Latvia at least have the luxury here of trying to side out to get it to 14-all. Canada need a break point. They need a point from the serving line. It is Alf, but will it be the same? It might be, it won't be. Everybody holding their breath then for Latvia can let it out now. They've survived their first match point. But now it's the first to get two clear to win. Change up here, going after Pavan, that doesn't work. Match point number two now for Canada. Crowd could be on their feet for a while here. Yeah, that's probably the best thing. Take a little seat because timeout's been called. Nice arm swing, but you can see her left arm doesn't come all the way up, it just comes back, so probably could get a little bit more height, could open up a little bit more. Even the world's top players aren't always perfect in every area, and for Pavan, she hasn't needed to be because she's so tall. And you see that a lot with players, that when they're tall, some of their techniques aren't what you might call textbook. Well, that's a let off. 15 all side switch will keep going until someone can get two clear. For Latvia, they've got to get 2 points from serving. It's a tough one for them. Canada, at least, if they side out, they only need one from serving. Deep breath from Anastasia. She sets herself. And Anastasia just made that move to the cross court and inside before the ball was played. And then made herself further away from the ball that went to the line. Match point number three for Canada. Is it third time lucky? Anastasia to keep Latvia in. It's a bit tight. Oh, and they've let it drop, and it's Canada who take bronze here in Stad. 17-15 in the decider. A cruel way for Latvia to lose it, but Canada don't care because they have bronze. They're on the podium. And it's another fourth place finish for Latvia. They equal their highest ever finish on the tour. Fabulous bronze medal match. The crowd loving it. Canada have taken the medal. Oh, it was a hard fought one. And a deep breath from Pavan. It wasn't quite to be. It was just that moment. This is blocked back. And you think, right, who's going to play it? Well, it should have been Anastasia. That's hers. It's right on her. It's right next to her. And as the inquiry goes on for Latvia, the celebrations start for Canada. Congratulations to Melissa. This is some of that moment. This is how it was done, really effectively. You just think, right, come on. But she's already, Anastasia's going out for a swing to think she's going to get the ball a second time. She needs to play that, then go out for the swing. And quite rightly, Tina's like, where are you going? One of those things that happens. Canada don't care. They've got the job done. They've done it the hard way. 2-1. They have bronze. Let's hear what they have to say.
Sarah, Melissa, congratulations, bronze medal here, another Swiss cowbell, but what an up and down in this game, what a thriller in the third. What made the difference at the end versus the Latvian girls?
The Latvian team is a really, really strong team. They've had a great season. It came down to pass set and taking care of our side out. We knew that they would score points, but we just had to be patient and keep fighting, take advantage of the opportunities when we got them.
Also, Sarah's block. That's the difference.
The whole week was a little up and down. What are you going to take with you on the road to Tokyo, to the Olympics?
This journey is not perfect, and you know, I think what's really important is that we grind together and we fight through those difficult moments, because perfection is impossible, and if we can just stay together and fight for every single point, then we'll be successful.
For you, Melissa, it's cowbell number 3. For you, already cowbell number 4. You can nearly start a farm back in Canada. What are you going to do with cowbell number 4 or 3?
We need to get some cows. You know what? I said this the other day. You can never have too many cowbells. They're the best ever. We love playing here. I hope you guys had fun, because we did too. And yeah, we're just so happy to be here.
Thank you, Sean.
Congratulations once again to Canada, and you're quite right, you can never have enough cowbells. You ask any of the players, this is one of their favourites, if not their favourite stop on the tour. It's proved to be a successful stop for Canada.
Und Brasilien hat bisher 9-mal Gold, 9-mal Silber und 6-mal Bronze gewonnen und erhöht jetzt eine garantiert auf 10-mal Gold und 10-mal Silber.
It's that top line that makes all the difference. Canada beating Latvia by 2-1. One more match to come here in Stade. It's the gold medal match. It's an all Brazilian affair. I do hope you can join me for that in just, really a few minutes' time. But for now, though, it is time to say goodbye.
Wilken noch bis zum Anpfiff werfen einen Blick auf den Medaillenspiegel der Damen, die schon erwähnt. Brasilien wird heute die 25. bis 26. Medaille machen. Hat zu seinen je 10 Gold.